Hi, I'm Dennis Tyler, Mayor of Muncie, Indiana. This Muncie Today show will be featuring all of our beautiful city parks in the city of Muncie, as well as Prairie Creek Reservoir, which is a city park just a few minutes outside of Muncie. You'll see a lot of Harvey Wright, our superintendent of the Muncie Parks, and you'll see Ivan Gregory, who's the superintendent of Prairie Creek Reservoir. You're going to see a lot of people in these videos enjoying our parks, families, children of all ages, seniors, people out walking their dogs, riding their bicycles on the trails through the parks and along the greenway. You'll see a lot of things in our parks that you should be very proud of. I hope you enjoy this video, and I'll see you at the end of it.
Harvey Wright, Muncie Park Superintendent, right here today touring the parks. And as you can see behind me, Tule Pool packed these warm days. I like to see all the people out using them. I believe last Saturday's date, I believe it was last Saturday, 1,150 total throughout the day was here at Tule Pool. And I'd say about half that at Prairie Creek Reservoir. So a lot of people out here taking advantage of these warm days. After the last couple years that we've had, I can't say that I blame them. That's what the parks is all about. We have them, total of 24 parks throughout the city of Muncie, including Prairie Creek. And like I said, take advantage of these days. Get those kids out from behind those video games and get them in the parks. Let them get a little exercise. We're coming up here on the High Street Bridge, and as we come across the bridge here, the flowers that the city has out here in the median is just unbelievable, especially this time of year. The four planters and five planters, and then the new landscape around City Hall really looks nice. The green grass, glad to see it back at Morningside Park here today. Kind of just going around the park looking and seeing some of the areas where I need some attention, some work we need to do. Problem that we're having here at Morningside, though, is as fast as we can fix them, vandalism's taking over. We're tired of the picnic tables and porta pots and such being dumped, picnic tables being dumped in Muncie Creek, all the graffiti around the shelter. We've fixed the water fountain several times each year for the last going on 4 years, as well as put a new sand volleyball pit in, and already replaced that net twice where people's just taking and cutting it up. We bought it for the people to use here in Morningside. Not for for them to stand by and let the park be vandalized. So, we need help with the neighborhood association, and we had spoken with Bob York, and this is their park out here. We'll do what we can, but we need their help once we do fix it. And like I said, we're working on some cameras right now. Get them here. And maybe if we prosecute a few of them, that'll hopefully hinder the vandalism from continuing. If we have to, we'll just sit the police down here, and then when they're not here, we'll have the cameras on, and cameras don't lie. They only record what they see. Once again, here at Heekin Park, in front of Cabin 5, which had to be one of the cabins that we've recently had re-roofed. All tore off, but new shingles on the complete cabin, as well as the porch had some structural damage, and got that all taken care of. People would probably remember on the east end of the cabin there on the porch area, it used to take a little dip. Now it's we got it all straightened out, refurbished, and ready for another 100 years of service to the community.
As you notice on cabin one here, that all the posts are new, and new guttering, that's something that the cabins have not had, is guttering. Before, we have put guttering on those, as well as new roofs on every one of the cabins here at Heekin Park and the cabin in McCullough. And we finished four of the shelters throughout the park system, one on being Thomas and Altshire, that really needed it bad. And we got those done. And another thing too that we'll get a picture of here just in a few minutes, all the parks have new metal signs now. All the wooden signs that's deteriorated and a lot of them falling apart have been replaced. And we want to thank community development for that. They have, Terry Witt Bailey has, and Kelly has really helped helped us with that. And Tom, before he retired, it's something that we appreciate, and something that the citizens of Muncie should appreciate, because these metal signs are going to be here for a while. It's not something we're going to have to go out and paint every year. It's metal, and like I said, definitely be there. They're structurally sound, so you won't have to worry about them rotting down. And very nice signs. And again, thanks to all involved with that grant and making this happen. And here we are at the new Cornerstone Park at Main and Madison. And as you can see the construction going on behind us, this will be a real nice park and a real nice addition to the Cornerstone, which is diagonally across the road. And then you got the Fireman's Park there right next to it. It's going to be a beautiful park, a place where, they'll be able to bring some people over with their classes from across the street at the Cornerstone, and they can have display their art and such, or even create some of their art here. It'll be a good place just to come and sit, read a book. It is just a kind of similar to a Cannon Commons, the amphitheater and stuff that you'll have here. Be more of a gazebo style, not real big for smaller gatherings and such. I'm sure through the years to come there'll be a little music here, but it'll not be anything like, what they have down at Cornerstone, but it will be the eastern gateway to the city of Muncie, and another great asset that Mayor Tyler's been responsible for bringing to the city of Muncie, and glad that the Parks Department can be a part of it. And I'd like to add one more thing to this here, the Cornerstone Park. We want to thank the George and Francis Ball Foundation, the Ball Foundation, Community Foundation, the Ziegler Foundation, everyone that was involved. Again, the city of Muncie, for making this happen. And Mayor Tyler, getting the group of people together to make this happen. And just goes back to what he said since day one. Imagine all the possibilities when we work together.
Hi, my name is Ivan Gregory. I'm the superintendent for Prairie Creek Reservoir. We're out here today just cruising the lake, seeing what's going on. We've had a great year so far this year. We've had Ironman this year, America Multisport Triathlon. We had several of them this year. Indiana Open Water Swim was a great day we had out here for, the kids to doing a swim meet. Ron Bottom Day, of course, we had a great time out here, fireworks and stuff like that. All together is pretty much a great season so far, mind the rain that we had, but great day today. It's about 82 degrees. The fishing's great out here. We have biologist out here. I can't say the name. But they shot the reservoir, and they pulled out quite a few fish, a lot of bass, bluegill, crappie, stuff like that, walleye. Walleye is very good. We've been stocking the reservoir since 2000 with walleye out here. Couple numbers, every time they stock it, it goes from 72,000 fingerlings walleyes to about 6,200 that we put in also. That's the spillway right there. That's where all the water goes out and goes into White River. But all in all, it's a pretty healthy lake. So this is the dam that we're coming up on right now. We're pulling through, holding all the water back. So Prairie Creek Reservoir is a great place to be. You know, if you have a pontoon or fishing boat or whatever you have out here, you know, we have 730 piers that you can dock your boat, your pontoon. We got 3.3 miles of water. It's almost a mile wide. Today it's, you know, 80 something plus today, and there's like nobody on the lake today. Great day. It's nice and calm. You know, just great place to be. Other things besides the water we have, we got 10.5 miles of horse trails that you can ride. It's just $5 a day, or you can buy a yearly pass for $25. ATV trails, I think we have 60 acres of ATV trails that we have out here also. Walking trails, and Ball Brothers Foundation just gave us another grant to extend our phase two of our walking trails and bike trails. They've been a great partner through us for the past years. Other than that, man, we have so much to do. Our beach, we have a great new facility for the beach. The beach has been doing very good this year. Good concession stand if you want a sub or hot dog or whatever, we have it pretty much. You know, the fishing is, you know, great out here. You know, you can drop a line in any bank if you want to go bank fishing. You know, you still have to have a state fishing license. Bank fishing is $3 a day or $15 a year. Just all in all, a good place to be. Here we are at the beach house. It's a weekday and festivities are going on. People's coming out, just now coming out to swim. It's probably about noon right now, and just having a great day out the lake. I'm here at the concession stand, and I'm here with Danita. She's one of our workers that works in the concession stand. And Danita, why don't you tell us what we got here?
Okay, well, we got fountain drinks, we have soda pop in the bottles, we have chips, we have hamburgers, we have hot dogs, popcorn, nachos, basically anything you can think of we have. We have subs, so it's all really, really good food. A lot of people love it, so especially our fountain drinks, we sell a lot of those.
All right, our concession stands and our new bathhouse is doing great this year. Great facility. It's just amazing from, you know, almost daylight to dark. It's just the difference that's done and improved this area. You know, I'm just excited waiting for phase three to come in to start working on our ADA, our handicap accessibility to where they can get in the water. I'm excited about the new things that's going to be coming out here at Prairie Creek Reservoir.
I hope you've enjoyed this video from Muncie Today on our Muncie City Parks. We're about halfway through the summer. School's getting ready to start again, but we got a lot of beautiful weather left to really get out and enjoy our parks. Please take the time to see all the great amenities that we have in our parks, all the great recreational equipment that we have in the parks, and all the children and families that are just having a great time in our parks this year. Thank you for watching this video of Muncie Today.